In this video, we'll be looking at the normal distribution and central limit theorem tool, and specifically the standard error of the mean calculation, which is just one of the calculations for the sampling distribution. And we'll be doing this calculation in Google Sheets. Now let's get started. So in the normal distribution and central limit theorem tool, we'll be looking at this calculation in here. And it is a pretty simple calculation. It's just a couple entries that we'll be entering, the standard deviation and the sample size. And this will calculate this symbol right here, which is population standard deviation. And then the subscript script is X bar. So it is essentially the standard deviation of the sample mean. Kind of interesting. So this is part of this is also known as the standard error, and we will be calculating this using Google Sheets with this tool, but we'll also be calculating the mean of the distribution of sample means. Not only the standard deviation of the distribution of sample means, but the mean. So that makes up the two main calculations that we'll be using. And from these, we'll be able to do a lot of other calculations, but we're just focusing mainly on this tool right here, the standard error. So looking at this example, we have a population has parameters mu equals 22.2 and a standard deviation of 16.5. So you intend to draw a random sample size of n equals 128. So sample size of 128. And so from this sample size of 128, we can calculate X bar. And that's why we have a subscript of X bar. And what we should visualize is repeating a sample size of 128 from this population over and over and over and over again. And each of these sample sizes of 128, we can calculate a sample mean. So each time we calculate a sample of 128, we can find one X bar, a sample mean, and as we do it over and over and over again, calculating a different N equals 128, we can calculate more and more X bars. And then if we plot all the X bars from N equals 128 over and over again, we'll eventually be able to describe that distribution of X bars by these two values, mu sub X bar and sigma sub X bar. This describes the distribution of X bars from n equals 128. So that's just a quick visualization you should be picturing when we deal with sampling distributions. And so the standard deviation of the distribution of sample means, also known as standard error, is what we're going to calculate. All right, so what we need is the standard deviation, which is 16.5, and the sample size. The sample size is 128. All right, so what we see here is that the standard error, sigma sub x bar, is 1.458 and so forth. So you'll always notice that the standard error is always smaller than the standard deviation. And I won't go into the detail of why, but because it's a bit complicated, but you'll just notice that. And if we were to determine mu sub x bar, that's really simple. So we don't even need Google Sheets to figure that out. And if you just think about it logically here, we think about, okay, if we were going to plot a bunch of x bars from a distribution of a population with a population mean of 22.2, so that's all we really need to think about is the population mean is 22.2, and we were to find an x bar and another x bar and another X bar from different sample sizes of 128, we would expect the average of all those X bars to be the population mean. Overall, the average of all the sample means should be centered at the population mean. So mu sub X bar is mu overall. So the solution to this first value is 22.2, and then we've calculated the standard deviation of the distribution of sample means, or standard error, is 1.458 and so forth. Okay, so anyways, that is how you define your sampling distribution. The sampling distribution is going to be normally distributed with a mean of mu sub x bar and a standard deviation of sigma sub x bar, also known as standard error.